Good morning, students. Today is our second session of your third unit. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about tree traversal. Last class we discussed about your basic concepts of your tree. Okay, so why we have to go for your tree data structure? Okay, in what type of applications we have to use your tree data structures? All these we discussed in our last class. And what are the basic terminology which is used in your tree data structure, isn't it? I'm going to recap those concepts once again, 2 minutes, okay? So let us refresh the topic. So first one is we discussed about tree data structure, isn't it? So how I can say or define the tree data structure is, tree is a non-linear data structure which is used to represent your hierarchical data. In a hierarchical form, we go for tree data structure. And this tree data structure is a collection of nodes in which nodes are connected by means of the edges. So what are the terms I used over here means I used nodes, edges, all those things, isn't it? Let me say that what do you mean by nodes, okay? So nodes is used to store the content or store the value, okay? So the, in this diagram, all these round part denotes the nodes, okay? So this is the simple tree representation, and we are going to, we discussed various terms, okay? That is a terminology which is used in your tree data structure. Isn't it? So let's see what are the terminology once again. So always you remember this one, you will have only one root element in your tree data structure. Okay, so you will have only one root element, or we call it as a grandparent, or this is very, very important. Okay, so this is the root element, we call it as a root. Okay, so this is the term used over here. And suppose if you don't have a root element in your tree, means I can't say that is a tree, then it is a empty. Okay, so always whenever you create a element, means I call that element as a root element. That is the first element will be marked as a root element. Okay, so next one, what is my edge? So edge means which is used to connect two nodes. So here you have 11 is one node and 7 is another node. Okay, so if I want to connect these two nodes, means I need one term. Okay, I use the term as a edge. Okay, so in this edge, it's used to transfer data between one node to another node. Okay, so that is the purpose of a edge. Next one is the parent node. Parent node means suppose if you have branches from that node, means I call it as a parent node. At least you should have one child. Say suppose let us consider a 7, okay, 7 particular node. For this particular node, I have two branches. So I can say that this particular node, 7 node, can be called as a parent node. And parent node can also be called as an internal node. So internal node is nothing but suppose if you have branches, means at least one branch, means I call it as a parent node or internal node. Then what is my leaf node? So suppose if you don't have any branches, if you don't have any child, means then I call it as a leaf node. So all these green color, okay, so these call it as a leaf node. And moreover, if I say it is a complete binary tree, means if you have n levels, means in all the levels nodes will be connected. Okay, if I call it as a complete binary tree, means your leaf node will be at the maximum level. Okay, so this is the point you have to remember. Next one is degree. Degree means how many branches are connected with your particular node. I call it as a degree. Say suppose for your 5, okay, let us consider this particular node. If I want to know what is the degree of this particular 5 nodes, means how many branches are connected with that? How many branches are connected? Only 2 branches are connected, isn't it? So degree of this particular node is 2. Okay, similarly for this node, root node, how many branches is going? Only 2 branches are going. This is the right branch, left branch, and this is the right branch. Okay, so I have only 2 branches, so I call it as a degree is 2 for this particular root node. And if I say this, so what is the degree of a leaf node? I don't have any roots, isn't it? If you don't have any roots means, then I can say that degree is zero. So this is how to calculate the degree. Okay. Next one, height and depth. So height is that you are going to see the height from the particular node to the last, that is your maximum level. Say suppose if I want to know what is the height of this 7 means, then I have to calculate the height from here to here. Okay, so this will be marked as a height. If I want to know the height of this 7, then how I will calculate, what is the procedure to calculate the height means. So from this 7, so from this level to this level, I have to calculate, isn't it? So what is the level? This is the one level and this is the second level. Then what will be the height of the 7? So height of the 7 will be 2. Okay, so this is how you have to calculate the height. Okay, so what is the depth means? Depth should be calculated from this particular node to the root node. So from this node to root node, so height is nothing but your, what is the height of this particular node? Height is nothing but your 7. And if I want to calculate the that is the depth means, I have to move from this particular node to root node. Okay, so from this node to root node means, so what will be the height? Height is nothing but 1. So sorry, the depth is nothing but 1. So d is nothing but d is equal to 1. So this is how you have to calculate the height. So and remember that height of your leaf node will be 0. Okay, can you follow this one? Because from this level to down, you have to see down, you don't have any branches. So for all the leaf node, your height will be marked as 0. And similarly for your depth node from for root node, if you want to know the depth of the root node means, from root node I can't see it from upwards, isn't it? I don't have any branches. So what will be the depth of this one? So depth should be marked as 0. So this is how you have to calculate the height and depth. Okay, I hope you follow this one. And next one, we discussed about different types of trees. Basically, the tree data structure can be classified into two types. One is the general tree, other one is the binary tree. Okay, so general tree means when you have a branches, more branches are allowed, means we call it as a general tree. Okay, so here the given diagram is a example of a binary tree. Okay, but in the case of a general tree, you will have a more number of branches like this. Okay, you will not have any restrictions. Suppose this is the example of a general tree. If n number of nodes are connected, branches are connected to a individual node, then I call this type of tree can be called as a general tree. Similarly, what is the other type means? Binary tree. Suppose if I have maximum only 2 nodes are allowed means, then that type of tree can be called as a binary tree. Okay, so I classify my trees into two types. One is a general tree, other one is a binary tree. Depends upon the structure I classified the trees, isn't it? Then in your syllabus, we mostly concentrate only on your binary trees. Okay, so we are going to see only about this binary data structure, binary tree data structure. So let's next class I will explain more detail about different types of binary trees. Okay, so this is the overall view of your previous class, only the basic concept we discussed in our previous class. So next, let us see on simple code. Okay, when you are clear in this simple code means, then easily you can write your own program in your any type of data structure. Okay, I want you to be more clear in this code. So why we are using this struct data structure? Okay, sorry, struct over here. So if I want to store one particular value, let us consider I want to store 10. Okay, this value to be stored means in C language or any language, what I will do, I will use a variable, isn't it? So this variable is used, one variable is used to store a value. So using this one, A is equal to 10, using this one I can store one value over this one. Say suppose what happens here when you use this one, automatically one address will be created. Okay, so one address is created for this one. Let us consider 6000. In this address, I am going to store this 10 value, isn't it? So A is a variable name, and I am going to store this 10 over here. So this is used to store only one value in your variable. Say suppose if I want to store n number of values, okay, I have let us consider sub 1000 numbers or 20 numbers or 1000 numbers, whatever may be. If I want to store more numbers, means it is very difficult to store variables like 1000 variables A, B, C, D, A1, B1, C1 like this, isn't it? So instead of that, I can go for a array concept. Okay, so why they introduced array concept means, in order to store n number of values which belongs to a similar data type, that is the same data type. If it is a numbers which belongs to a integer data types, n numbers which belongs to a integer data types, means then I go for a array concept. Say suppose if I want to store a different data types, I want to store a float, I want to store a integer or string, whatever may be. If I want to go for a different data type, means then there exists a concept called a struct. Okay, so the struct concept is used to store, it is a user defined one which is used to store different data types. Okay, so that is the use of a struct. So why we are using in your if you see in your from your linear data structure, if I say list, stack, queue, or whatever may be, we using the struct data structure, isn't it? Then what is the use of that one? If I say node, means you might have seen that for this particular node, all the nodes are connected with other nodes. If I want to connect other nodes, means how they are connected, means by means of address only they are connected. Okay, so even though I have a same data type, inside that one I should need another field. It's nothing but a pointer field. So I need one that is a container. In that container, I have to store value as well as the pointer, means definitely I can't go for a that is the array concept, because in array concept I can have only the similar data type. If I want to store a different data types, means definitely I have to go for another concept. That concept I have a structure. Okay, so by using this struct concept, I can store that is the data or otherwise the address. So therefore, if you see this, any data structure will be using this particular code. Okay, so let us explain this one in more detail clear. So if I say tree data structure, in your tree data structure, you'll be using a nodes. Each node will consist of three fields. One is a data field, other one is a left address field, other one is right address field. So these three fields are used in all tree data structure. Okay, so in this, so if I want to store a data, this data will be a integer, float, string, character, whatever may be. But if I say a left child address or right child address, definitely it will be your pointer. That is you have to store the address over here. If I want to store a address, means if I want to access the address, means definitely I have to include the pointer concept over here. So this pointer concept is not at all very tough. Actually, you can easily, if you know to use the pointers over here, it is very easy to implement your coding. Okay, so let's see how we can use that one. So this in your structure, I already said that this struct is used to define, that is a declare a different data type, isn't it? So you all know that, let us assume that data is a integer data type. So I am going to declare this data as an integer data type. Okay, next one is left child and right child should be marked as a pointer, because if you say this, let us consider this node. Okay, this particular node, if I want to connect this left child and right child, okay, this is a left child and this is your right child. If I want to connect this left child and right child, means that what I have to do, I have to take the address of this left child and I have to connect it over here. Similarly, I have to take the address of right child and I have to connect it over here. Isn't it? To do this, what I have to do, I have to use the pointer concept. So in order to declare the pointer, I've used this left and right over here, and this is the way to declare your pointer. So left is a pointer variable. Similarly, right is also a pointer variable. Can you see this one? So this left is a pointer variable, right is a pointer variable. Now I got the whole package of a node. This is a node. This node package contains the data left, right, isn't it? So now the data can have some integer value, and left, right is a pointer which I can store the address. I hope you understand. So here I want to store the address. For left and right, I'm using the pointer variable over here. Okay, so this is the purpose of your structure. So next, let us assume that I have declared the structure. Now I have to create a address, isn't it? In order to store the address over here, what I have to do, or in order to store, in order to create a particular node, okay, let us consider I have to create this particular node. Initial node means I have to create an address. So how will I create an address in C language means? So this is the statement which is used to create a node for a particular C language, okay? That is struct node. This is the user defined data type. Suppose if it is a predefined one, integer means how we will define int data, isn't it? So this is the already inbuilt declaration. For integer we are using int. Then this is data is the user defined variable, isn't it? Similarly, this is the predefined, that is the user defined that is the declaration part. So struct node asterisk, I'm going to use a node, okay? Here I can use node one or node whatever may be. Next one, node asterisk malloc size of struct node. So why I'm using this one means I should know what is the size of this particular container, okay? So in order to know this size, so I have to use this malloc function. Using this malloc function, it will allocate the size and address will be generated. That address is stored in this particular node, okay? So now let us consider one address is generated and that address is stored is over here. So this is your node. Okay, can you follow this one? This is the node. This node contains, okay, so this node contains three fields. One is a data field, other one is the left address, other one is the right address. Now I generated one address. That address is stored in node. Say suppose if I generated this 5000 means, so that 5000 is stored over here. Now this node contains 5000 and that 5000 is stored over here. Can you follow this one? Now what are the things I have to do? I have to create data in order to store this data value over here. Let us assume that I want to store 15 over here. Means then what I have to do? I have to accept the value. So using the scanf statement, I'm going to accept the data. Then after accepting data, I have to store the data in a node, isn't it? So what I have to do means I have to use this statement node of data. So this node contains what is the value which is present in your node. This particular node contains 5000 which is created from this statement. Okay, so after executing this statement, I will get 5000. That 5000 is stored over this node. Now when I execute this statement, what happens? 5000 of data that is equal to this data. What is the value which is entered over here? Let us assume that 15 is entered. So that 15 is stored over here. Okay, can you follow this one? Now node of data contains 15. That is nothing but 5000 of data is equal to 15. And listen here, this is different from this. This is a normal data type and this data is already we declared in a structure. Okay, so node of data is equal to data. So 15 is added over here. So now 5000 of data contains 15. So this is how you have to do it. Okay, now let us assume that I have created only one node. I have to fill your left child address and right child address, isn't it? So let us assume that initially I have created only one node. I am going to mark that left child address and right child address as null because I have not created any other child or left or right. Okay, So initially I'm going to mark it as left address as an null and right address as null. Then after that I'm going to display the values, node data value, left address value and right address value. So now what will be the value of this one means, so now what is the node address? Node address is 5000. So 5000 of data, so 5000 of data, what value will get means, you will get the value as 15. And for this left and right will be getting the null value. Okay, so let us see that if it is a integer data type, I have to use it as a percentages. If it is a pointer means, then I have to use the pointer p. Okay, so if I use this one, let us see what happens over here. So I'm going to execute this code and let's see what will be the output of this one. Okay, so using online compiler, okay ma, I am going to execute this particular code. Let us see how, what is the output you are getting. You can take this online compiler like this, okay, online C compiler. Okay, so in this online C compiler, first you take this online GDB compiler. Can you see this one, ma? Please, anyone, please post this one in your chat. Yes, can you see this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Just I'm going to copy this code over here. So when I run this, okay, so you have a buttons over here, debug. Okay, so when you debug over here, what happens means you are going to compile this program. So after compiling this program, you are getting some warning messages. So what is the warning message means? So you are, have been used your pointer, but in your printf statement you used a percentage d. So when you are using a pointer in a percentage d means, so what happens means the value will be in a integer format. Okay, that is in a normal thing. Suppose when you want to know the address in a hexadecimal means, then you have to go for a percentage p. Okay, so here I'm running this one. So enter the data, some data is 45. So after this one, see here, so no data is 45 and left node I marked as 0, okay, and right node, because I don't have any value in left node and right node, so value is marked over in, and address of this particular node address is 6299664. Some random dynamic address is generated over here, and for this particular node, left child value is 0 and right child, that is your address, is 0. Okay, this is nothing but address. So because you have not created anything, just you have marked the address as null, isn't it? So it is showing that address is 0 and right address is 0. And what is the node data? Node data is 45. Okay, so if I change this one, so here instead of using percentage d, I'm going to use a p, because this is a pointer variable. Okay, so here this is also a pointer variable, left right, and this one I'm going to mark it as a pointer variable. Okay, so you have to declare, this is the right way of using your printf statement.
Okay, now let us run this program. Let's see what happens over here. Now you're not getting any warning messages. So now I'm going to enter the value as 50. So see here, so I'm this after executing this statement, okay, so node is created, so I'm asking to enter the data. Okay, so this is a print statement. It is asking you to enter the data. So after that entering the data, so that value is stored in your node of data. Okay, so that value is stored over here. So now see here, so it is in a pointer. Okay, I'm asking it to display in a pointer. So what happens means, so left is null is given, isn't it? So therefore node of left, okay, showing that a nil, and similarly node of right shows as a nil. And what is the node address of this particular one node means it's showing it's like this. Okay, so this is the difference between using a P and a D. Okay, this is what we have done means just we have created only one node. We have created only one node, and in your left child I have marked as a null, and right child I have marked as null. Say suppose if I want to create a node for your left as well as the right, and I have to store some value in a left and a right child means, then what will be the procedure? Then what I have to do? So instead of using this null over here, okay, so instead of using null, what I can do means I have to create a node. So what is the procedure to create a node? I have to use this statement, isn't it? So I'm going to use this statement. So here I'm not going to use a null variable over here. And now let me see what is the value of left child and right child. Okay, so now I have created one node, one simple node, and I'm going to display the node address. So after that, what I'm doing is I'm creating a left child and right child, okay, and I'm going to display the address over here. Let's see what happens over here. So 15, I have created one node, parent node, okay. So after creating the parent node, so this is the node address, parent node address. And node left address is this is thing, okay. So 0x224c030, this is your left child address, and this is your right child address. Now just now we created only the left child and right child. I have not assigned any value to that left child or right child, isn't it? Suppose if I want to assign some value to that one means, then what I have to do? Node of left, okay. So now I created a node address. So what is the node of left? 0x224c030, isn't it? So after executing this statement, node of left, I've created this address. Now this particular address, for this left, I have to insert a some data. So let us assume that for this particular, now time being, I'm going to use a node of left. For that particular left, I'm going to assign some data value. Let us assume that 56, okay? So let us assume like this, and for a node of right, okay, so node of right, I'm going to assign some value, node of right of data, let it be 95, okay. For this 95, let us assume that value. Now I want to display the value of node of left of data. So what will be the procedure? So this is the integer data type. Data is an integer data type. This is not an address. So I'm going to use a D, and node of left of, how I have to use? Node of left of data, okay? Similarly, for right side, I'm going to use right of data. Then I'm going to close it, okay? And let me see when I run this program, what will be the answer for this one? So to send. So I'm going to enter the data for a root node, let it be 15, okay? So after entering the data, so node data is 15 and node address is this particular address. Okay, node of left is this 0xDA, something like this, and node of right is this one, and node left value is 56 and node left value is 95. Okay, so I showed only one node I have created and left child I have created. I have not linked your left child with your node or right child with you, just I have created that one. This is a very simple program to create one single node, and which that particular node having a left child or right child. Say suppose if I have a n number of, I have to create a n number of nodes, means then if I use this procedure it won't work, isn't it? So for this purpose what I have to do means I used a recursion concept. So next class I will explain how we can use a recursion concept over here. So I just want you to be clear what is the use of using the struct and how we are creating a address for a particular node, how we are inserting value to that particular data, all those things. Okay, I hope now you clear how you create a particular node and how you entered a data over that and how we create a left child address and right child address. Is it clear, ma? If this is clear, means then yes, is it clear? Yes, please. Okay, ma. If it is clear, means let us move on to our today's session. Okay, have a 10 minutes time. Okay, first one is let's see what today's topic, that is the tree traversal. Okay, tree traversal, what is the purpose of this tree traversal? If I say this linear data structure, means it is in a sequential order, isn't it? So from your first node, I can move to your second node, I move to your third node, and it goes on like this. Say suppose if it is a non-linear data structure, maybe a tree or graph, means I cannot visit in a linear form because it is arranged in a non-linear. It is in a hierarchical form or it is in a random form, isn't it? So if I want to visit, if I want to print element, or if I want to search any particular element, then I go for some other technique in a non-linear data structure. So that technique we are going to study in your traversal concept. So traversal concept is nothing but how you are going to visit a particular node in a data structure is nothing but your traversal. So I repeat once again, traversal is nothing but visiting a node in a tree is nothing but your traversal. Okay, so let's see this one. Before entering into this traversal, you should be clear in subtree concept. Okay, so once again I'm going to explain the subtree concept. Okay, let us see what is the subtree concept. So for this subtree means, let us see this one. So before entering into this traversal, let's see the subtree. So for this particular, let us assume that this is a general tree. Okay, for this general tree, for this A, okay, this is a what is a A? A is nothing but your root node, isn't it? So for this root node, you have two branches. So this is one full branch, okay? So this is the right branch and this is your left branch, isn't it? So this right contains that this whole thing comes under your left subtree of this A, okay? Similarly, this is a left, this is right. So this is left and this is right. Okay, so the whole thing, this whole thing comes under your left subtree of this particular root node A. Okay, similarly, this whole thing will comes under your right subtree of your this node element A, that is a root element A. Similarly, if I want to categorize a subtree, means let us assume this B node. Okay, this particular B node, this whole thing will be called as a subtree of your B. Similarly, this is this can also be called as a one subtree, and this one also be called as another subtree. Can you follow this one? Similarly, this particular C node, the whole thing will be considered as a one left subtree of a C node, and this will be called as a right subtree of a C node. Similarly, for this G node, okay,
this particular G node, I have a, this is called as a one subtree of a G node. And for leaf node, you will not have any subtree because you don't have any branches. So I cannot categorize any subtree over there. So this is a concept of your subtree. Let's see one small introduction about your traversal. Okay, for this traversal tree traversal, already said that what is the use of a traversal, isn't it? So traversal means in order to visit a particular element in a data structure, I use a traversal concept. Okay, because this is a nonlinear data structure, one after other I can't go, because it is in a hierarchical representation. If I am in a, this particular node, means I will be in confusion whether I have to visit this particular node or this particular node. Say suppose if I am in this particular node, means I'll be in a confusion whether I have to visit this one or this one. So suppose if it is in a, I am in a B node, okay? So if my current node is in a B node, means I'll be in a confusion whether I have to visit this D node or E node or F node, because all these three nodes are connected this B node, isn't it? So in which criteria I have to visit, what way I have to travel over there? So for that, they introduced one concept, they call it as a tree traversal concept. Can you follow this one? So in your tree traversal concept, I have three types. One is the in order, other one is the pre-order, post-order. Mostly you'll be using these three types of your traversal, okay? In order traversal, pre-order traversal, post-order traversal. This level order traversal is a special case. It's a very simple thing, okay? So these are the four types of traversal which you'll be using in your tree data structure. So in order to visit, in order to search a particular node, means we are using this traversal method. So what are the traversal method? In order traversal, pre-order traversal, post-order traversal, and level order traversal. These four order traversal are used in tree data structure. Okay, within this I will end this today's class. Okay, so next class, let us see more detail about all these concepts. Okay, so any doubt, ma'am? Students, if you have any doubt, please ask me. Any doubt?